friends, let us continue with our another lecture of microprocessor. This will be our lecture number 6 and we will continue with the assembly language.
Start.
See how to assemble, link and execute the assembly language program. These are some of the steps suggested for us. Step and operation is written at the left side. So editing or writing the program. We need notepad or word for writing the program. We need some software. That will be the notepad or word program. Output will be in the form of file name with .asm extension file. Second step is assemble. So input will be file name and the software will be the MASM for this, and the output will be in the object file will be generated. Third step will be linking, link. So input will be the object file, software will be the link software, and you will get output as the executable file for this. So how to build executable programs? We need editor program like Notepad, Word. Then we will get some file with the ASM extension. Then assembler checks syntax and translates source code into machine code like MASM. We will get the object file. Then there will be the linker software and we will get the executable file. If there are some errors, then it will be debugged or code review if any error will be there. So the important uses of the assembly language tools, first one, editor. A text editor is required in order to create assembly language source files where you will be writing your code. You can use Notepad, DOS editor or any other editor of your choice that produces plain ASCII text files. Then the debugger. A debugger program allows tracing of program execution and examination of registers and memory content. For 16-bit programs, MASM's debugger named CodeView can be used to debug. The assembler source file, it will consider and syntax will be checked and translated source files into the machine language code so that our object files will be created. An assembler is a program that converts source code program written in assembly language into object files in machine language. Popular assemblers include MASM, that is Macro Assembler from Microsoft, TASM, that is Turbo Assembler from Borland, NASM, that is Netware Assembler for both Windows and Linux, and GNU Assembler distributed by the Free Software Foundations. The linker, a linker program combines your program's object file created by the assembler with other object files and link libraries, producing a single executable program. You need a linker utility to produce executable files. Two linkers, that is link.exe and link32.exe, are provided with the MASM 6.15 distribution to link 16-bit real address mode and 32-bit protected address mode programs respectively. Now the meaning of assembler directives. It provides information to assist the assembler in producing executable code. It creates storage for a variable and initializes it. Assembler directives, that is pseudo instructions, gives directions to the assembler about how it should translate the assembly language instructions into machine code. Whereas other instructions discussed in the above section give command to the 8086 microprocessor. Assembler directives are specific for a particular assembler. However, all the popular assemblers like the Intel 8086 Macro Assembler, the Turbo Assembler and the IBM Macro Assembler use common assembler directives. The basic structure of a program in ASM will look like this. This is the structure of a program. For example, program for addition of two 8-bit numbers is shown here. So this is the assume directive. Here it initializes the code segment register with the label as code and the data segment register with the label name as the data. This is the declaration of the data segment. Two values are considered here and the sum will be stored in a reserved variable. So declaration of data segment will end here, and this is the initialization of the code segment. It will start with the code segment. This is the code. Move AL, EN1, take the first number into the AL register, take the second number into the BL register, add the BL with the AL and store the sum from the AL into the final variable called as a sum register. And this is the code ends or end of the program. These are the assembler directives. These are the assembler directives. This is the program. Some of the assembler directives are discussed here. The assume directive tells the assembler the name of the logical segment it should use for a specified segment. It associates segment names with segment register. For example, assume CS code tells assembler that the instructions for program are in the logical segment named as code. Similarly, for assume DS data tells the assembler that any programming instruction refers to the data segment, then it should use the logical segment named data. For example, in the instruction move AX, BX, the memory segment referred by the BX is in logical segments data. Similarly, the 8086 contains a segment register DS that is dedicated to data memory segment. This register is the default segment register used for all memory references used for the data. The user is responsible loading the data segment register with the appropriate value and telling the assembler where the DS register points so that it can calculate the offsets correctly. The standard is to define a segment to be a data segment. This is a convenient way of keeping data and code separate. The most common way of doing this is declaration, data segment, then values, and then end data ends, indicates the end of the data segment. Hence, the assume directive is required to inform assembler of location of DS pointed by assume DS colon data. Data directive, data storage directive, each variable has a data type and is assigned a memory address by the program. Data directives are used to reserve and provide name for memory location in data segment. The symbols used for data types are data type byte and symbol is B, word W, double word D, quad word Q and 10 bytes T. For byte variable, we should use DB for declaration. For example, N1DB4 initialize variable N1 with value 4 in decimal and N2DBAFH initialize variable N2 with value AF in hex. In hex. Name DB Zetwa allocates 6 bytes with variable name. Okay, so in this way it will be initialized. This is the DUP operator used to create arrays of elements whose initialized value is same. The basic syntax, for example, is count DUP initial value. For example, N1DB100DUP0 means create 100 bytes array with value 0 in each. Similarly, when question mark is there means there is no uninitialized words. So that is reserved there.